With space, time, and chaos, and the threat of war looming, there was a comeback. Yuri, a once chilling name, reverberated over the free world again, creating new chaos and havoc. Those who would defend freedom were assembled into armies to fight valiantly. The key to the fate of mankind is now in your hands. Fight and fight at all costs.
Hello everyone and welcome to Command & Conquer Rattlelord OL. This is the Chinese Rattlelord mobile game that was recently released. Is it sanctioned by EA? I'm not entirely sure. There are a lot of games on Chinese mobile stores that use Rattlelord assets, so I kind of have my doubts here, but it could be. It doesn't really matter. We're going to check it out. Unfortunately, my Mandarin is rather lacking, so what these guys here say, I have no idea. But let's unfold our MCV here. Yeah, don't expect much from this game here. This is not going to be an actual Command & Conquer game. This is probably just going to be another Clash of whatever clone. So let's build our refinery here. And it's of course going to take a while. From what I've heard about this game here, it's essentially your standard mobile game. You build buildings, there's countdowns, you can use actual money to reduce the countdowns and stuff. And it looks very much like Rattlelord 2, in fact, it looks like a more interesting version. But overall, I think it's just another game that makes itself unplayable, so you spend money on it, so it becomes more playable. But we'll see how far we get here before I either lose the patience or it gets unplayable, or I run into a point where I can't really continue the game without understanding Mandarin. Any case, so we do have the Rattlelord buildings here, and here we have a, is that Tesla tank? Not entirely sure. Anyway, regarding the game's plot, you could hear that during the introduction, which actually uses English audio in Chinese subtitles. Yuri, or Phantom as he's known, apparently in the Chinese version of Rattlelord 2, threatens the world, and a bunch of fabulous characters here have been assembled to stop him, like this guy here, who's got fabulous hair and looks very snazzy. Well, this certainly has an interesting aesthetic here. So far I can follow it quite nicely, but well, they just require me to click on everything and everything blinks. So let's see how much of this I can actually remember. Steady foundation, that's good to know. Here's another very stylish character. I'm going to leave this on screen a little bit longer just in case some of you can read Mandarin so you can catch up with the text. I'm not quite sure what this guy here is saying, but the basic plot seems to see that commanders are assembled from different either timelines or dimensions or both to combat the threat that Yuri presents, and this seems to be, I don't know if this guy is supposed to be like a basic GI, but he seems to be our intelligence officer, sort of, or at least fulfill the role that an intelligence officer has. The game doesn't actually look terrible. There are these rather flashy anime characters, but on the other hand, like, these aesthetics here don't look bad if they did a remaster of Rattlelord 2, which in my opinion isn't really necessary. If it looked like this, I wouldn't even mind it so much. So we have our resources here, our crystals and gold coins and yeah, diamonds and gold coins actually. That, and we have apparently explosive barrels. I guess that's a resource here. And we're upgrading something here? I'm not entirely sure. I think we are. Okay, so there we go. Something happened. From what I understand, this game does have your usual incremental upgrades. And so you have to either wait or buy stuff. Oh dear, do I have to do something myself without them telling us, or telling me what exactly I have to click? Well, let's see. Okay, did I upgrade this guy here? Maybe I did. Okay. Was that good or bad? Let's click this one here. Oh, helicopter. Is that a Black Hawk? Possibly. Let's click this one here. Well, looks like we made it out of that menu. Well, well done, I guess. And that's a character, that's for sure. Yeah, I apologize for this game being rather vertical, but it only seems to run in this format here. And we strengthen the police. That's good to know. Strong police force. Always good, unless you live in a police state, then it's probably not. Not perfectly lip-synced, but that's okay. If I remember correctly, 7Q10. Whatever this means. I honestly don't know. Do I have to click this? I guess I do. 100%, that's nice.
Hello, can you hear me? Great, this channel works. I'm Special Agent Tanya, and I'm responsible for doing dirty work for the Alliance Army. I think General Carvel told you about me. He was my mentor. Listen up, rookie. Yuri is searching for people like you to use for the time portal experiment. There should be blueprints for the radar station in the database. Build the radar as soon as possible so that we can monitor the movements of Yuri. I'll contact you again. Take care.
Well, that was Agent Tanya. And that was also really poorly lip-synced. Maybe that's homage to, like, a badly dubbed 1970s Chinese martial arts films. I don't know. Anyway, what I do know is that Warminer? We need 250-something for that? Whatever. Can we get any of this? Possibly. Let's click this one here. Okay. Is that good or bad? Not entirely sure. What's with this? Well, let's see. Okay, let's go with this here. And apparently our prism towers here are damaged. I guess we can do something about that. And construction is complete. So, yeah, we want to build a radar tower, Tanya said so much. So I actually sort of understand that. What does this do? I guess we can upgrade more stuff here.
Construction complete. Construction complete.
Okay, and now we have a gate. That is great, I suppose. Oh, a barracks. That's nice. Yeah, if I hadn't played Red Alert 2, then I probably wouldn't know what any of this meant. But then again, if I hadn't played Red Alert 2, I probably wouldn't play this game here, so... Oh well. What does any of this mean? Here we have some sort of countdown. I guess that's that the time it takes until this here is finished. This one here looks good to me, maybe. Honestly, I don't know what I'm doing here. Let's check out this one here. We can get crystals, explosive barrels, and liquid tiberium? I don't know. Anyway, let's just see. We've got this icon here. What does that mean? I don't know. Oh, we can purchase stuff here. Yeah. I don't think I'm going to bother with that. How do I get out of here? There's no close button. Oh dear. I made a mistake. I'm pretty sure I did. Oh well. Whoops. Whoa, whoa, whoa. How did that happen? I don't know. Yeah, you can't see what I'm clicking on the screen here because I made the mouse invisible. Everything else is kind of irritating. But let's see. Anything else I can upgrade here? This one here? Suppose I can. And our barracks is apparently ready in 17 seconds. So let's just wait here. Can I fix you? Okay, so, but I don't want to build this, I want to fix it. Well, anyway, so let's just check out our base while we're here. We have some space here. This is our AWP purifier. We've got a chronosphere. We've got allied flags here and whatever that is. Got some units. Can we actually move you? Doesn't look like we can select you. But it doesn't look like we can actually do anything with you. And it doesn't seem like I can even select these guys. This here is closed off. So yeah, it appears we are restricted to our base for the time being. Also, wow, this refinery is tiny. Look at this. Now look at our barracks here. That is, man, that's the world's tiniest refinery. Or is it supposed to be a perspective thing? Also this, oh, I thought it was Japanese, but it's just reverse Swiss colors. Never mind. Anyway, can I move you guys? I don't know. Let's try to fix this. I guess I can use my currency for that.
Construction complete.
Is that good or bad? I don't know. Let's select this one here. And whoops. Anyway, let's just not bother with that. And what is that? What did I do? I don't know. Let's check. I don't know. That's probably their store or whatever. So what are we even supposed to do? Let's see. So this seems to, oh yeah, haha. It's our usual collection thingy. So these produce our resources here, explosive barrels and diamonds, and then we can upgrade them so they produce more. So this is probably the usual mobile game upgrade loop where you upgrade stuff so you can upgrade more stuff, and then you can, yeah, let's use this one here.
Construction complete.
There we go.
Construction complete.
And what do we even spend on this? Whoops. Whatever. Can I build more of these? I suppose I can. Let's build another one of these. And then let's build another oil derrick here so we can do something. And so which resources are actually decreasing here? Let's see. What does this tell us? Whoa, 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 whoa. What is this? Wow, this almost looks like actual Red Alert 2.
I am but a student.
You are but a student? Okay, so that's just wild buildings here. So are these just various bases from various players? Also, unit is ready, that's good to know. Can we check this out? I don't know what any of this means. We do have various construction yards here, or what is this? I don't know, this looks fancy, but I don't really care. Let's just go back. And let's see, so we have, whoops, whatever that is. Yeah, apologize for me being so clumsy, but I really don't know what any of this means. And, okay, apparently we have to wait 24 hours till something happens. Let's check this one here out. I just want to go back to that base. Oh, there we go. Well, I guess that was easy. So we can collect whatever that is. Ooh, we got something there, I assume. These ones here are probably going to produce your resource as well. This one here seems to have been double upgraded. Thank you very much for using Arabic numbers here. That was useful. Ooh, look at that. Crates. I dropped some coffins here. That's good to know. And, whoop, okay. Never mind. Can we... Whatever that is. What does this mean? Okay. Never mind. So, can we do anything else here? So we kind of want to fix this. Can we move our units? Because if we can, then I don't know why. There's a nice allied hologram here. And ooh, hey, ooh, I didn't even see the aircraft carrier. Fancy, fancy, but it doesn't seem like we can actually interact with anything. And I don't know, what's going to happen here? Are they going to attack us? Do you send like units from base to base or something like that? Maybe you do. Also, what is that? Huh, I guess more tutorial stuff. Well, oh hey, there's Professor Einstein. That's good to know. Green numbers that go up, that sounds good to me. And I suppose this is our commander. And maybe this one here is. I don't know. Yeah, if you have any clue about what's going on, feel free to let me know. I apologize for coming poorly prepared, but there's only so much I could actually find on this game here, whatever that is. So we can, do we need a tech lab to repair stuff? maybe we do. Let's just build one. So apparently we do have one now. What does this mean? I have no idea. Let's just go back and let's check. Have these guys here produced us anything? They have not, but that's okay. There's also some sort of vault here. Whatever that means. Yeah. Okay, so I guess we can buy stuff here. Either exchange resources or there's some sort of shop with different tiers. And we have another counter on here, which probably means we can unlock more stuff after that. We did have whatever that was. There we go. So, have we purchased repair stuff? Maybe we have. Let's see. Blue lightning, that sounds good to me. Okay, so what does this mean? Oh, okay, so don't have enough coins for that anyway. So can we do anything here? I'm still curious about that. So it asks us whether we want to spend our coins on that, I suppose.
Construction complete.
Okay, or did you just improve our gate here? So I'm not quite sure how this works. I think that happened the last time as well. Let's see whether we can produce any units here. Let's check out our arms factory here. Okay, let's upgrade it. Because why not? There we go. And let's see. You have the power, indeed. So I guess that is the Tesla tank, after all. So yeah. Hmm. Oh, so this just leads us here. Okay. Well, we have brutes here. They're very, very purple. Yeah, I still don't know how this is supposed to work. Can we attack other strongholds here? We can. Well, look at that. Look, I actually figured out something here. Exciting, exciting. So, huh. So do I do anything here, or do you just build troops, send them over to the enemy stronghold, and then something happens, and you either win or lose? So did we destroy this, and now they're returning home? Who knows? So did anything happen here? Maybe not, but maybe nothing should have happened, because this is apparently a level 8 stronghold or whatever. Can we do anything with this? Ooh, whoa. Can we change this? I guess we can. So this is our attack power. It would fit because we do have these units here. And apparently we have these two commanders here. Let's see. Ah, there we go. So see? It's not that hard. Look, they even copied the cursor here. So let's see how... Are those Mirage tanks? So 3 Mirage tanks. 5 GIs and... These Blackhawks here do against a single Yuri initiate. Well, he's dead now, and apparently we won. Isn't that exciting? Not quite sure we couldn't attack this base here. Maybe the game doesn't allow you to do that right away. Also, what is going on here? Well, but it looks like we won our first battle. Isn't that exciting? Is it our last battle? We shall see about that. I might play this for a little bit longer, but don't make any bets. I think this is enough for now. Thanks for watching, and I shall see you next time. Take care and goodbye.